And for the opportunity to offer some thoughts on a special occasion, I consider it a significant honor to be asked to say a few words about my dear friend, Dr. Gail Lenz. Do not cry. Perhaps unlike many of you, my contact with Janet has primarily been outside her career path. As other speakers today have pointed out, Janet worked hard to earn special distinctions and a well-deserved professional and academic reputation. She's a special person. I consider Janet a special person for reasons unrelated to her career and her academic work. I'm going to share a little information about the side of Janet that I am familiar with. A side of her that some of you may never have had the good fortune to experience, and a side of her that makes her very special to us. I met Janet more than 30 years ago. I was moved to Tallahassee in 1985 when I attended a Sunday afternoon covered dish dinner sponsored by a local canoe club. It was at this function I first met Janet. We sparked up a conversation and the two of us decided to join others in the club the next week in the kayak section of the Swan River known as Big Shoals. Never in my imagination did I believe this chance encounter would result in friendship that endured all these years. Over the years, Janet and I have hiked miles of trails, camped in some pretty interesting places, whitewater kayaked in Kudu rivers, traveled to parts of the U.S., and shared happy times with friends and the Champagne girls such as Sean, Debbie, Joan, and Jill. Who knew Janet loves garage sales? Who here has not enjoyed your mom's special recipe of vinegar, lichen, pecan, cinnamon, coffee cake? Did you know she owns her own ice skates? We are all familiar with her secret mild addiction to chocolate. I had a Girl Scout trip for 9 years. Janet must have made it a requirement of her students to purchase Girl Scout cookies, as Janet was always at the top of our troop cookie sales. I wish there had been a cookie badge to give her. As part of her strategic delivery network, Bob was called upon many times to deliver cases of these Girl Scout cookies to the Career Center for distribution. I graduated from FSU when my daughters were small. Remember when the Career Center was housed in Bryan Hall behind Ruby Diamond? When on campus for class, I would walk by the Bryan Hall for a quick visit with Janet. If the weather was good, she would have her window open, we could chat. Ironically, our youngest daughter lived and took classes in Bryan Hall her first term at FSU. I remember on one early kayak trip in Alabama when the weather was cold and afternoon storms were expected, a decision needed to be made as to whether to stay or drive home. We made the decision as to whether to paddle that particular day or head back to Tallahassee by relying on Janet's well-known analytical method. Specifically, we constructed a pro and con table and condensation of I knew right then and there that woman took decision-making seriously. We also survived a week of whitewater canoeing the Buffalo River in Arkansas, despite tent camping on uncomfortable rocks and the ever-present ticks. On this trip, she taught me the song, Round Round, and we were a pretty good pair navigating the whitewater rapids, sometimes screaming the entire way down the rapids. Just Janet, as well as Bob, have become important figures in the lives of our daughters. Janet and Bob have provided both professional and personal wisdom to our daughters as they embark on their career. Our daughters have shorthand references for Janet and Bob, AJ for Aunt Janet, and UB for Uncle Bob. The pro and con table I first saw on the vehicle windshield so many years ago has been used a lot in helping the girls make life decisions on where to go to college, graduate school, where to live and work. Janet has provided the girls with a strong role model as a woman in a time when having that level of independence, intelligence, and confidence has not always been worn. My friendship with Janet means so much to me that it's difficult to put into words. She is affectionate, attentive, despite her busy life, always available, brave, caring, cheerful, especially after her morning coffee. Considerate, most often easygoing, empathetic, faithful, forgiving, funny, extremely generous, an amazing listener. She's honest, she's humorous, she's kind, She's loving, she's loyal, she's optimistic, extremely reliable, sympathetic, thoughtful, trustworthy, warm-hearted, and wonderful.
Mentioning that open window in Brian Ball, the day I came in, sat in my office and there was this little possum sitting on it. Just memories, just. So, about a week ago, Dr. Lenz and I were having lunch, something we do fairly regularly, and I mentioned that I'd seen the program for her retirement event, and I was listed as a speaker. She immediately expressed dismay about this and indicated that that was a mistake. Why you, she asked. I indicated some agreement about that, but that I checked with Director Hoover, and the program was being printed. Dr. Lenz then asked, well, what are you going to say? And she observed that I should be careful what you talk about, don't steal my lines, and don't use any of my speaking time. So they keep from wondering if I'm going to speak with a script. So why me? Well, that was a good question, and I wondered if my 50 or so years of hanging around counseling and career services at FSU may have had something to do with it. Or maybe it was because I had been recently identified as Dr. Lenz's senior intern. You remember the Robert De Niro movie? So what to say, Dr. Lenz and I have multiple roles and relationships. When I attempted to sort them out, I counted about a dozen, including senior intern. Sometimes these roles are obvious and sometimes not. For example, when we do workshops in various places, some participants are surprised to learn we're married. And some of you here today might not have known that. But we're here to honor Dr. Janet Gale Lenz and celebrate her contributions in making our lives and programs better for students at FSU and elsewhere. So in this year, I'll focus on my role as her professional work colleague. To do that, I checked my vita, my professional work history, and found the name Lenz appeared 172 times in it. No one else's name appeared as often. Her name appeared 15 times in relation to books, 31 times for refereed articles, and 72 times for professional presentations and workshops. Much would be missing in my professional life except for Dr. Lenz. This is a remarkable situation, I think, and I suspect it is unique in the lives of most people. Further inspection of my vita revealed that Dr. Lenz and I had presented together in 10 countries, ranging from Iceland to China. In addition, our work had taken us to 22 states across the U.S. I have literally been able to travel and experience many things with many people worldwide as a result of Lenz's work at FSU. These data reveal that I owe a great deal to Dr. Lenz for achievements in my own career journey, and I know that many of you have data revealing similar things about your lives and careers. The stories about Janet shared today around these tables by alumni, colleagues, friends, and family are filled with gratitude, humor, respect, and admiration. So we salute you. Colleague, friend, partner, what a remarkable legacy you have created for us. Thank you for it all, my FSU colleague, your senior intern, and more.